We're excavating a hole approximately 200 feet by 200 feet by about 28 feet deep.
Rule of thumb is we basically like to get 1,000 yards a day.
Some people are just amazed at where all the dirt goes, but it just goes out one truckload at a time. About 2,000 truckloads of material. It's beautiful sand. And this is the old tidal flats from the Charles River. So this is all natural sand that's just been deposited from the glaciers. It makes it real easy to deal with. You can push it with the bulldozers.
Wow, this is like a walk on the beach. It's not like you can just come in here and dig a great big hole and move dirt, you know what I mean? You gotta kind of plan your strategy and where you're gonna go and how you're gonna come out of it. Once we come in and start digging, we go to town.
So they install the slurry wall, which consists of these concrete panels that go down about 80 feet into the ground. When you're digging a hole, naturally the walls are gonna wanna come in towards the job. So that bracing is basically what's holding up the excavation, making the job safe for everybody.
Rain or shine, we come in, you know, we really don't stop for too much.
What we're trying to do is achieve bottom of the excavation so that the concrete subcontractor can come in and put his footings in, and then they can start erecting the steel.
We dig up some old wood, artifacts. I wish we could find some gold.
You'll see the excavation going down in tiers, and then all of a sudden, it'll start coming right up and out of the ground.